talking about dooming, I bitched about the lack of meaningful node war changes in today's labs, and one of the SACMs told me, wait for the upcoming dev video in a matter of weeks. So it seems like there's a big node war patch in the works with a J YouTube video either done or being made. I'm gonna be honest. No one's gonna be here for that. Like, I feel like their idea of changing node wars, and this is the brutal truth, their idea of changing node wars is to upgrade the current system for node wars, which is just simply not going to work. This RBF thing that they have going on is just not going to work. So unless their big announcement is to roll back, I'll give you my feedback. Here's my official feedback for node wars and how I think that we can fix it. Because I'm not trying to just doom about it. I do have a solution in mind that I think will work for node wars. Okay. Some of what they currently have actually is relevant. So I think that their ideas of bigger rewards for node wars, lower prep time for leadership cores, and less politics is an objectively good thing. Okay, all of those things are good things. So we need to keep what works about the current system, and you take what people liked about the old system and you put them together. Okay. In this case, what you do is you take preconceived ideas of a node war zone. Okay, so in this case, I will use Nevern's Step, because this is a good one to show. Okay, and let's say that six guilds, you just sign up for node wars, kind of like how you do now with the current system. You just sign up for node wars and the game handles everything else. Okay. You don't get to choose what team you're on. You don't get to choose who you're allied with. It doesn't matter. Okay, the game's gonna do this for you. And what the game does is if four people sign up for Node Wars, it puts them on Nevern's Step. So if four people sign up for Cap Node Wars, it puts those guilds together on Nevern's Step, right? And now if there's a lot of guilds, they could put them on multiple nodes in variations of, you know, three or four or two or whatever. In this case, I'm gonna use an example that four guilds signed up for Node Wars on Uncapped. Okay, so let's say that four guilds sign up for Uncapped node war. Okay, and what you do, what the system should automatically do, is it should already have preset bases that are built like the old node war system. The bases are already built and it automatically aligns you with another team, like another team member. So it structures guilds, it places guilds, it ranks them as like the first rank guild. Okay, then you have the second rank guild, you have the third rank guild, and you have the fourth rank guild. You say, Blue, how is it going to determine which guilds are stronger than which? Well, there's a lot of ways that you could do this, but the developers have already talked about adding hashtag PvP into the game, designating your guild like a life skilling guild or a PvP guild or whatever, and then earning points towards being a PvP guild, earning points towards being a PvE guild, or earning points towards being a life skilling guild. Okay, so what you could do is you could take that system that they're already developing and you implement it into the node war system. Okay, and you take the top ranked PvP guild based on points, okay, and you put them with the fourth ranked PvP guild. So guilds 1 and 4 are on the same team against guilds 2 and 3. Okay, and it will automatically determine this based on their like guild point ranking. Okay, so like you can't determine what guild is going to be on your team, and you can't determine what guilds are necessarily going to be on the enemy team. You're just placed on a team and it's going to build the base for you in a designated location on the same side of the node. So guilds 1 and 4 will be on the same side of the node together and they can't attack each other. They're allied with each other, okay? And then the other two guilds, by contrast, are built on the other side of the node. Guilds 2 and 3 can't hit each other and are working with each other, okay? Then these guilds attack each other, okay? Whichever side happens to win, let's say guilds 2 and 3 win, they wipe out guild 1. Okay. And then they take down guild 4, right? And then they 2v1 guild 4. Both of these guilds would be given victor rewards, and both of these guilds would be given participation rewards, so long as, you know, at least 100 of them died, right? And whatnot. So there's some flaws with this system, and I'm going to get into that in a second. And there's ways to avoid all of this. But what this does is it takes what's good about the current Node War system, which is not having to like build your base or do politics or whatever. No politics, right? Easier on leadership cores, keeps the really good rewards, etc. And it also includes the competitiveness of the old Node War system. Okay, so like these guilds get like as close to they can as fair fights. Not every fight is going to be fair, right? So like it is what it is in that regard, but like you get it to as close as possible, and that's how the Node War system has always worked. You try to get it to as close to a fair fight or as close to an even fight as you can, and you kind of just take have as much fun as you can. Okay, like this system would work generally really well. Now how do you deal with snipe guilds? Really easy. If you don't declare yourself a PvP guild, you can't be yesed up. Yeah, or, I mean, you can't Node War. Okay, you don't declare yourself a PvP guild, you can't Node War. If you do declare yourself a PvP guild, guess what? You can be decked on by other PvP guilds. Wow, holy crazy. And then you just let the community handle the problem. Okay, so if a guild tries to declare themselves a PvP guild and then doesn't show up for the fight, do you think the Corrupt's going to handle that super well? No. Okay, this discourages snipe guilds in a very healthy way from showing up and then not showing up, right? It encourages guilds to participate and have fun with each other. Okay, and it's not toxic, right? Because they consented to being a PvP guild, all right? This is just how it goes. Also, again, I think it dramatically decreases snipe guilds because snipe guilds know that they're going to have a teammate and that they actually have to fight. The whole idea behind snipe guilds currently is that, okay, if we drop, someone else might just not be there and we might just get the node for free. That's really not an option with the new Node War system. The game is going to put you with another guild automatically. Okay, and this is going to discourage snipe guilds all around, because unless literally no other guilds drop, you're going to have a teammate or you're going to have an enemy, and that, and then you're just going to get bulldozed. Okay, and that's just how it goes. So like, I think it discourages snipes, and then I think that you can also bring back like one-sided decks in just in the PvP guilds. And then the PvE guilds can't be decked on, the life skilling guilds can't be decked on, and if you declare yourself a PvP guild, you know, you're ready for PvP, so like, you know, you can be decked on. You could also have it so that guilds can't declare war, like an uncapped guild can't declare war against a T1 guild. They can only declare war against other uncapped guilds or capped guilds or whatever, or however you want to do it, right? Unless they consent, right? If both sides accept, then okay, then you're fine. But like, if you're worried about something like Digital decking on nerds, right? Digital is like the strongest guild in North America right now, decking on nerds, which is kind of a staple T1 guild in North America. Okay, well then you can just have it so that uncapped guilds can't one-sided deck T1 guilds. It's just how it is. And like, it's really simple. But if you drop and you declare as a PvP guild and drop an uncapped, you should be able to be decked on all of the uncapped PvP guilds because you're declaring that your guild is ready for that. Okay, this will also deter snipe guilds. Okay, you're also going to have the problem where people might try and go and make secondary guilds that like don't have points, right? So that they get ranked lower on the system when their guild is actually higher. This is not going to happen super frequently, at least not in the West at all. I don't think that Korea is really going to do all this either because they don't ever want to leave their guilds. For any reason, this would require you to drop guild and go to a new guild shell in order to PvP. And then the second you could do this like once or twice, but then your guild is automatically going to have enough points and be ranked way higher. So you could do it like once or twice, but then you got to drop guild, go back to your other guild. And by the way, that one's already got the points. It just doesn't make any sense. So like you can't really feasibly make a Smurf guild and have it work more than like two times in Node Wars without it just destroying itself. Because of how this system works. So like, this is really hard to kind of exploit. It includes aspects of the old Node War system, It includes aspects of the new Node War system. And to be clear, when I say that the game should build these bases, I mean the old bases. There should be recovery centers, LA nurseries, flame towers, and Hawatches on defense, okay? And flag factories on defense. And then you should have to place flags on offense to push guilds, okay? Like, it should be just like the old system like this, but it's already pre-built, preconceived, and you avoid all these politics. This is my honest feedback for how I think that they could change the Node War system. I think that when you have, there's also going to be questions, well, what do we do? And, well, what if only three guilds sign up? What do you do? Not every fight is going to be perfect, right? And we all know this if you've been in Node Wars for a long time. You already know that, like, not every fight's perfect. You kind of just make the most of it, right? So you just have guild one fight guilds two and three. Okay, two and three are automatically allied together and they fight guild one. That's just how it goes. Like, sometimes guild one, believe it or not, is going to win that. Sometimes guild two and three are going to win that. But you make it the most fun that you can. Okay, what about a 1v1v1? I think that we've demonstrated that a free-for-all format is not fun in any way. A 1v1v1 never ends up being a 1v1v1 for any reason. And if you've ever been in a situation like this, you know. One guild always ends up being attacked by two guilds. And free-for-alls are not a fun format. And I'm going to emphasize, FFA is not fun, okay? Free-for-all is not a fun format for Node Wars, okay? It's not a fun format for anything. FFA is not a fun game mode. It's not fun in tournaments. It's not fun in Node Wars. It's not fun in RBF. It's not fun, period. And the reason is, I'll explain this, because this is also important for the developers to hear. Free-for-all is not fun because in order for there to be good PvP, I need to make the font smaller. There needs to be competition. Okay? Good PvP means there needs to be competition. All right? In a free-for-all, you don't feel... free-for-all, especially in Black Desert, you don't feel like you're competing with the other guilds as much as it's just kind of a clown fiesta. You don't really know who's stronger, right? You don't really understand who the weaker or the stronger guild is. You don't have dominance over anyone. And in PvP, the entire reason you do PvP is to demonstrate to other people, whether it be your guild members, the people listening in Discord, your viewers, whoever, that you are better. Or even if it's just your opponent, that you are better than them, right? This is the general nature of PvP. This is not toxic. This is just guys being guys. It's just the truth. Now, I also want to point out something that the developers seem to misunderstand. Competition is not toxic, necessarily. Okay? Competition does not mean toxicity. Right now, competition, in the developer's eyes, the developers see competitiveness, rivalry. People use the word rivalry a lot. I'll put it, okay, as toxicity, all right? And I want to be very clear that rivalry and competition are synonyms in this case, but they don't necessarily mean that you're going to be toxic, okay? Like, toxicity, there is some toxicity that comes with rivalry and competition. Nobody wants to lose, all right? Nobody wants to be a loser, but that's part of what drives PvP, right? In AOS, Arena of Solaire is a perfect example. Does this perfectly. Arena of Solaire does this very, very well, okay? I'm actually just gonna make an arrow. Competition is not mean toxicity, okay? In fact, I'm just gonna delete this arrow because I'm trying to make this as easy to understand for the developers as possible, okay? Arena of Solaire does this really well because you create competition between players. You're trying to beat the other Dark Knights, right? You're trying to be the best Zerker. You're trying to be the best wizard or witch, right? And you're trying to get as far up the list as you can. It's not because you hate them or you're trying to be toxic or you're calling them dog shit or you're trying to dox them or anything. It's because you just want to be better than them, okay? That rivalry, that competition is good. That's why people like Solaire, Okay. Is there toxicity in Arena of Solaire? You bet your sweet bippies there is, right? You bet their sweet bippies there is. And that's where I'm going to emphasize that you just have to enforce your terms of service, okay? When there's toxic, when the competition and the healthy rivalry of PvP becomes too much and it, the behavior does become toxic, that's when you just need to simply enforce your terms of service. If people are telling other players to kill themselves, if people are telling other players that they're going to find them IRL or that they should drink bleach, right? Or anything like this, or they're saying racial or homophobic slurs, you simply ban those players. It's really not that hard. So you can have healthy rivalry and competition in PvP without being toxic at all, simply by enforcing the TOS appropriately. It is literally just this simple. So all of this to say, okay, in summation here, okay, you need competition / rivalry for healthy PvP. Okay, toxicity does not always need to be a part of PvP. Okay, you can have both. In order to minimize toxicity, you can ban players who exploit it. Okay? It's literally just this simple. Okay? If a player kills another player, it is not inherently toxic, as Jay believes. All right? In a lot of cases, the player that gets killed is probably going to stand up and say, okay, I need to go grind all my gear. They're going to play the game more because they got killed. Because they're probably angry that they died and they looked like an idiot. Okay? It only really becomes overly toxic. And to be clear, most chat PvP is also pretty harmless overall. Okay? So like, most players, if you can't handle somebody telling you to go get a job at Subway after they farm you in PvP, you should probably not be doing PvP. Okay? The game has a lot of different aspects. There's PvE, there's life skilling, there's boat content, there's all kinds of other stuff that you can do. If your mental simply cannot handle somebody saying the word fuck to you, okay, you should probably not PvP. And I mean that in the sincerest form possible. Because most of the time when you die in PvP, you're probably going to take the next thing that person says very personally. Okay? Most players are going to be like, damn, you suck. You know what I mean? And you have to be able to stomach that. And if you can't, okay, then you're probably not going to be a good PvPer. You should probably just step away. You should probably just step away. Because oftentimes, those same players that can't handle that toxicity are the most toxic players in our community. I'll say it again. The players that can't handle somebody telling them to f*** off or that they suck often grow into the most toxic players in the Black Desert community. Okay? What they do in retaliation for that becomes much, much worse. All right. If you find yourself getting really hot and bothered by players saying stuff, you can always turn off the chat. There's profanity filters. There's ways you can block people. Right. Doesn't matter. Right. Doesn't matter. Just block them. Doesn't matter. And if you really feel like you need to vent your frustrations in a certain way, you can just ban players for being toxic. It's really not that hard. Right. Players are always going to shit talk. In any game, in any PvP format, players are going to shit talk each other, okay? Shit talk is not necessarily a crazy bad thing. There's some shit talk that's just part of the game. But then there's a lot of shit talk where, hey, there's like a line where like, hey, you crossed that line. Okay, now that's toxic, okay? And that player should be banned. It's up to Pearl Abyss to decide where that line is. And I think they've made it really clear, right? Banter's a part of PvP culture in every game. Yeah, keep it in Discord. And keep it in Discord. Like, and no one should be harassing somebody in IRL for any reason for what happens in game. It's obnoxious. Right. But yeah. So we need to bring back competition and rivalry in PvP. Okay. This needs to be brought back. Jay can still have what he wants. He's trying to minimize toxicity. Okay. He's trying to minimize toxicity. And that's a good thing. We want to reinforce that minimizing toxicity in the PvP community is a good thing. There's always going to be some toxicity, and that's just the way that it goes. But if you remove competition from PvP, you kill PvP. The current node war system does not have competition in PvP because it is a free-for-all. Okay? At no point should you ever be a free-for-all. If it's a if there are three guilds dropped, it should be a 1v3. If there's two guilds dropped, it's a 1v1 flat out. If there's four guilds dropped, it's a 2v2, right? If there's five guilds dropped, and this is where it gets interesting, five guilds drop, okay? Then you take guilds one and two, and you put them against three or five. Not that hard, okay? Or if you really want to be crazy, you can put guilds one and three against two, four, five, okay? And this is probably the best way to do it, is to put guilds one and three together and put guilds two, four, and five. Because see, then guild two has to attack, or guild one ends up fending off guilds four and five, and guild two is going to try to push down guild three, right? Either way, it's still a fun format, right? Even if you do guilds one and two versus three, four, five, people are still having a much better time than they are currently having with this current node war system. They're having a better time than they would have had with the old node war system. They're having a better time than they would have had with the risk system that we had. This system that I have laid out, this hybrid system, is probably the best node war system that we could ever hope for in Black Desert with our current limitations. At least in my opinion. I'm curious if people agree with me. This is my genuine feedback on node wars and what they can do to fix it based on what they've told us they're already developing for the game. I think it's absolutely doable. I think that it would be a lot of fun, and it would bring a lot of rivalry and competition back to PvP, which makes healthy PvP. I just think that they can just enforce their terms of service where they have to, and players will just stop innately being toxic because they know that they will get banned. Anyway, let me know what you think in the comments.